Hi there, YouTube.
We're going to take it easy tonight. We're going to do something that I'm good at for the sake of something that I don't know. We're going to sight read. Not sight read. We're not going to sight read tonight because my brain can't handle that tonight. We're going to learn a jazz standard by ear. Because I need to know that. A stream where I learn a song by ear. Cool. Go live. Okay. Well, here we go. We're going to try to learn a jazz standard. And let's see, let me real quick. Oh, let's go back over here. There we go. Face and window. Window capture. 50 jazz standards you need to know. Here we go. There we go. That's what we're going to look at. So, here's our list. You can see it. I'm going to go, let's see. What's it going? We sort of know Fly Me to the Moon. Should we just start at the top and work our way down? I've worked on All of Me before. Let's do it. I'm just going to learn it by ear. We're going to learn the chord progression, and then we're going to maybe see if we can learn any of the leads, the melodies, but we're going to start with the chord progression, just by ear, all of it. First, you need to tune it, though, so let's go ahead and do that. There it is. Pretty good. There we go. Okay, let's listen to it. See what this sounds like. Oh, you know what I should do? No, you can't hear that. We want to make sure you hear it. That was a fun noise. let's go desktop audio properties. Voice meter. Now we're gonna do Focusrite. Does that work? Hey, you can hear it. Look at that. So, yeah, we're just gonna go through and try to learn the chord progression of this. Here goes. No. Thank you. Oh, we got a key change in there somewhere. Well, I guess we're gonna have to chart this out, because the last one we learned, what was it? Blue Bossa? Was just... God, I don't remember it even. But it was the same chord progression the whole time.
This has some changes.
So we're gonna have to chart it. Bruh, there's a freaking ant. This might be meticulous, but we're going to take our time and just do it. We're going to do the whole thing. So, starts in C. Hold me. C. Full measure for a full, yeah. Boom. We're gonna call that A. Boom, boom, boom. A minor this time. There's a chance that might be A7 or D7. Just call it D for now. I think it goes from D to D minor. Ooh, and there's some speeds up there. Could have been... F. There's a D. Diminished. What would that be though? Maybe E? Let's see what's this. No. Too spicy. Thank you. measure per. And I'm sure these are all more complex than. Than just the simple. So C E A D E A D. D minor G. C E A D F E A. Even less than a minute in. Christ. Okay, well. So maybe if we were to do this functionally, which isn't even useful because it starts in C and then goes to E major, which is not diatonic to C. Okay. Which means there is modulation here. I just have to figure out where the modulation is. It's like C. Is that just the whole loop? So C. D. Are you this out of tune already? My God. Start to see if I can play along with that. Thank you. streaming me to me?
I am. I said hot shit, babe.
Hot shit.
Hot shit.
Oh, is it Tinder stream? I want to see. Hot shit, babe.
Hot shit, babe. I shared it too.
I have a viewer.
It's me.
Yeah.
I'm going to send you a heart. I'm your biggest fan.
Yeah.
I'm
just playing through it. It's getting to this point where, like, I don't know what the chords are. Well, I don't know if it repeats or not. I feel like it doesn't, honestly. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Wait, 1, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's 12. Okay, well. You don't have to. You don't even see it. All that matters is that I understand what it means.
Screw you.
Just kidding. I love you. So let's go back. Huh?
Huh?
Nothing. Turn around. The turnaround. There it is. The end of the measure. Learned that by ear. This is what it looks like right here. What all do I have on here? Oh yeah, nothing really. I'll show you real quick. So it starts off here. See? E. You know what, let's do this real quick. So C, right here, starts is where it starts. It's kind of in the key of C. Sort of. I don't know. Jazz is weird. It does a lot of modulation. It's kind of in the key of all the bunch of different stuff. Starts in C, goes to E, A, D minor. All this basically up to here was all pretty straightforward. It's like, oh, I just find the root, and the bass is at the root. Some of it I might be a little off just because there could be inversions, but I don't. We'll see. I don't know. But with this, yeah, this was the chord progression I had. It does a, let's see, it's first like section is right here from C to G, where it goes 2-5, D minor, G, C is 2-5-1. That's how you know it's called a turnaround in jazz. It's when you, because 2 is the dominant of 5, is the dominant of 1. So 2 pulls to 5, pulls to 1, is kind of how that works. And then it goes C, E, A, D minor. So all that's kind of similar. And then it starts to change a little bit. It goes F, which is like a, what is that of C? C is the 4. Which 4 is a fun chord. It can be tonicized very, very easily, and if you spend too long there, it can feel like home. Usually, though, it just feels, in general, it feels like the subdominant, so like the thing loosely leading to the dominant, the 5. But yeah, then we've got this half, this half note, like half measure, E to A, D minor to G, and then that turnaround again. So D minor G, C, D minor G, and then back to the start. So just this one leads back to here, and it just goes through that whole thing a bunch of times. The tricky part is going to be one, analyzing it and understanding what's actually happening, because this is trickier than it, so let's look at it for a sec. So we've got C, because that's the key of the song. It's where we start and it's where we end up with this G. So if we start with C, E is just a third of the scale. It's an E major, so what we could call it is the sub the 5 of what is A, the subdominant of A, if that makes sense. The 2 of 3, or the 5 of 3 is rather what we would call this. 5 of like a major 3. Which is tonicized, the E is tonicizing that A, which I think is in turn tonicizing the D. Let me real quick get out my circle. Do I have a circle of fifths? Maybe I can draw it real quick. We can do a quick music lesson. So it would be at the top C. C, and there's two in between C, G. D, A, E, down and ends battle. Alright, so then we got F, B, flat, E, flat, A, flat, D, flat. Oh gosh. Then yeah, G flat. G flat at the bottom. So the way this usually splits up is just like this. Yeah, G flat is the tritone, and across is tritone. Cool. This is the way we split it up. Right here. So this is our circle of fifths. So C to E, we're just going to a subdominant. So C to the subdominant, or the two of A, the five of A. A is the five of D, I believe, right? Because E, yep, to A. A to D, D to E. That's just that's kind of staying in that. The if D minor is tonicized, we're just staying with the E. D minor. Yeah, kind of, sort of. Let's see what that sounds like. All right, we got, what was it? C. Ugh. E, A, D minor. So yeah, okay. I think what it's again, it's that subdominant. So we're in D, A, tonicized D minor. The D minor is going to the subdominant with E of A. E is tonicizing that A minor. It's like a harmonic minor, kind of, so like this. It's this little, like, half-step resolution, which is fun. So yeah, E to A, that's the subdominant. A, again, I think, to D, yeah. And then there's this little plagal thing. Not plagal, so like, to D. So D to G, yeah, another. Yeah, so we're just going, it's just going, the whole song is basically just going up the circle of fifths this way. And then D minor to G, and then back C, which is five, to G, or to C, I mean. And then that same, five of three, I guess. That goes to F, so D minor. So this is, so I think this little moment here, C to E, that's that subdominant. And A. A is a brief caveat from the key of C, and when we get to D minor, we're going back to it. So it's D minor, which is the minor 2, we go to F, which is the major 4, subdominant again, 2, 5, sick. That's the analysis we're going to go with. I'm going to go ahead and write it down, and I'll show you. So we've got 1, 2, no wait, 5 of 3, major 3, which makes, I've never learned actually how to notate this. What it's doing, though, is it's tonicizing the A, and I've never learned how to Roman numerally, like, notate that. We're just gonna call it the... We're just gonna call it 1 prime, is what we're gonna call it. Actually, no, we're not. We're not gonna call it that. We're gonna call it the major 3, because the key largely stays in... C, I think. It doesn't, though. It's just like lots of modulation. So C to E, E to A. Or, yeah, I don't know. Maybe we should call it 1 prime. 1 prime, which is... No? you call it? That's my question. Is like, how do you Roman numerally notate this? We know what they're all doing. Like, this is leading to that. Is leading to that. Is, well, no, that is just the key. And then that leads to that, leads to that. And then that leads to that. Leads to that. Leads to that, leads to that. So it's just like this chain of dominance. Well, now we know that. And interestingly enough, that's like how a lot of jazz works. It's just using those like subdominants and just the circle of fifths, just zooping straight up the circle of fifths. So yeah, that was a good little session. Took me just over 40 minutes to understand it and break it apart. Cool. Huh? Yeah, you can hear me. God, it would suck if you couldn't hear me. So yeah, anyway, that's that. Hope you liked that. Hope you learned something. I'm gonna maybe try to solo over this tomorrow. Just like sit with it and try to play over the changes. You know, play, because you know you can't play a C major scale over A major. Well, C major. You could play C major pentatonic, I guess. And you can play any note over any scale over any key. Any note works. There's only 12 and all of them work. You just gotta know how to use them. But I think learning to play over the changes, make it palatable for people to listen to is important. God, why are there so many ants? Holy shit. We're good. We are good. It's fine. Anyway, I'll see y'all tomorrow. Have a good night. It's the weekend. Enjoy it. I'll see you next time. Bye. Same to you, YouTube. Nobody has hit me up about writing them a song, so still waiting. Just let me know.